Hey everybody, it's Rich at RMAutodiag, and today we're lying underneath a Nissan Navara, and we are going to have a look at the speedo sensor and see why this car's speedo isn't working.
Okay, so first things first, we've got this plugged in. It's a D22 Nissan Navara 2002, and we'll just see if we've got any fault codes. As I say, the speedo doesn't work at all, no gauge movement, everything else on the dash works. So if we go into engine, and we'll see if we've got any codes. And yep, vehicle speed sensor circuit. Not too informative, but you know, we'll deal with it. Right, so we know that that doesn't work. It's not showing anything on the dash. I don't know if it'll have any data. These are fairly basic, these older ones, so I'm not expecting to see any data on vehicle speed anyway. Okay, RPM. We do have vehicle speed there. That's not too bad. I'll take it for a drive and make sure that that doesn't move or change. But as I say, there's nothing on the dash. I'll take it for a quick drive and then we'll get underneath and have a look.
Right, okay, so we've got the speed sensor here. And if we follow that up, I've got it disconnected down this end. We've just got a 2-pin plug. And it goes up to here. And that's where it goes back into the vehicle harness. So I'm assuming from it being a 2-pin plug, it's going to be an analog sensor that should give us a sine wave when the wheels are turning. First check is I'll get the camera set up and we'll do continuity across these pins and just check to see if it's open circuit or not. Okay, all I've got, it's a bit dark. You can see I got my two wires hooked up into the sensor side, and we've got the other end attached to the multimeter, which we can see there now. So we've got about 300 ohms, just under 295 ohms, so we're definitely not open circuit. So what we can do next is if we turn our meter onto volts, and I'll go into the other end of the loom and we'll see if we've got any voltage in there. Okay, so we've got the multimeter back probed into it there. We're just going to see if we do have any voltage on it. It's like a seeking signal, and we don't. We've just got millivolts there. So I think next thing we'll do is we'll get an old speed sensor out of a gearbox. I've got one lying around that I know works. I'm going to jump it into the wiring for the actual rest of the truck up here, and we're going to turn it and make our own AC sine wave, and we'll see if the speedo drive works up in the cab, and we'll see it on live data. And I think that's going to be the quickest way of proving this. I know it's a bit cheating getting another part, but it's just one lying around, so I just use it for testing, you know, making that sort of signal for these old analog sensors. It can also be useful for making like ABS signals off old sensors as well. So, you know, once you've got one, you can use it for other test plans anyway as well. So I'll get that set up and we'll see if we can make the drive work, and we'll go from there. Right, okay, sorry about the bit of glare there, but I think we can see it. And what I've got is I've got a speed sensor out of a gearbox, just an old one. I've got that jumped into the wiring loom for the car, just up here. And what we're going to do, as you might have already noticed, we're going to spin it up. And there we go. We can see that we've got a signal coming out. just with that, I'd say this is the cheapest way that I'm going to make an AC sine wave, just having an old sensor lying around. And that proves that all our wiring's good. That proves the speedo works, which it does up there. I've checked that as well. And that's a pretty good test. So that only leaves the actual speed sensor here as the only component that could not be working. So there's either the chance that the plastic drive might be damaged inside of here and it's not turning, which is a possibility, or whatever turns the drive inside the gearbox is damaged. Sadly here today, I don't have the ability to take it out and drop all the gearbox oil, because the guy needs to take it on. So we'll have to get that out and get that checked. But I mean, it's pretty obvious from there. We're just doing the diag on it. So if it needs a new speedo drive, then if it's taken out and it's all in place, then it's all good. It'll need a new drive. If the drive's stripped, then it'll still need a new drive. So yeah, that's pretty well it for a quick check through. Hopefully you found this fairly informative, and don't forget to come back for the next one. Cheers.